Large language models have literally conquered the world by this point. The native data modality used by large language models is obviously text. However, given their power, an active research domain is to try to harness their strong capabilities for other data modalities. And we already see large language models that can understand images. Today, we're diving into an intriguing paper from Nvidia titled LLaMA-Mesh, Unifying 3D Mesh Generation with Language Models. In this paper, Nvidia researchers were able to transform a large language model into a 3D mesh expert, teaching it to understand and generate 3D mesh objects, calling it LLaMA-Mesh. Given a prompt, LLaMA-Mesh can generate a 3D mesh object, such as the cube here, and it works the other way around as well. We can feed the language model with a cube, ask it what shape it is, and it can recognize and say it is a cube. We can see such examples in the demo taken from their GitHub page. On the left, the model is requested to generate a lamp, and on the right, the model is asked to recognize a shape, identifying it as a wooden barrel. In the paper, they also share the following gallery of objects generated by LLaMA-Mesh, which is quite impressive. Let's now understand how a large language model, which was trained on text, can understand and generate 3D objects. The answer is by using a format called OBJ, which is a text-based standard for 3D objects. We can learn about it using the following figure from the paper. On the right, we have a 3D object of a person, and on the left, we see a sample from that object's OBJ representation. The rows that start with V represent vertices in the three-dimensional space using x, y, and z coordinates. These are the positions of the points of the object. Note, we only see here a sample of the representation in this example, since in practice there are more vertices. The rows that start with F represent faces, which specify a list of vertices that make up a surface. By reading and generating such a format, the LLM can work with 3D objects. We just render its output using standard tools for that format. A note about that format is that the vertices coordinates are actually provided as decimal values, but in the following figure from the paper, we can see that we convert the vertices coordinates to integers. The purpose of this quantization is to reduce the number of tokens, since for decimal values, we use more tokens for a single digit. So, we gain significant savings in the model's cost, trading off with some reduced precision when doing the quantization. If you're finding this content valuable, don't forget to subscribe and hit the like button to support the channel. We also send 1-minute read summaries by mail about the papers we review here. You may find the link to join in the description of this video. Let's now move on to understand how the LLaMA-Mesh model was built. First, the researchers noticed that some spatial knowledge is already embedded in pre-trained large language models. A possible reason for this could be the inclusion of 3D tutorials in the pre-training data, for example. However, the quality of their 3D object generations was not satisfactory. The model which the researchers chose to work with is LLaMA-3.18B Instruct. To improve its mesh understanding and generation capabilities, the researchers constructed a dataset of text 3D instructions. Then, they fine-tuned the model on that dataset using supervised fine-tuning. We can see a few examples from the dataset in the following figure from the paper. The first type of samples is for mesh generation, where they take an object from an existing dataset and they automatically generate a sample like we see here, simply using the object label to create a prompt asking the model to generate the object and use the actual object as the response. The second type of samples are for mesh understanding, where they again take an object from an existing dataset. This time they use it in the prompt and add an instruction for the model to recognize the object using the label of the object in the response. These two types are generated with simple rules, and in addition to that, they also use augmentation to create dialogue samples with both text and 3D objects. Let's now see some results presented in the paper. In the following figure, we can see a comparison of generations with other strong mesh generation models. LLaMA-Mesh generations are in the bottom row, showing competitive quality with the other models. However, LLaMA-Mesh has the advantage of being able to communicate with both text and 3D objects. We can see another interesting result in the following table, where the researchers check whether LLaMA-Mesh preserves the language capabilities of the pre-trained model. Observing the LLaMA-Mesh model results in blue, there is some hit in performance comparing to the pre-trained 8 billion parameters model. However, the results are still better than the 3 billion parameters version of LLaMA 3.2. Thank you for watching and stay tuned for more reviews of AI papers